Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is my first video on YouTube. So this video is about Kolmogorov-Arnold network, a game challenger in deep learning. It is proposed as a promising alternative to multi-layer perceptrons. So if you are looking for an alternative to multi-layer perceptrons, let's get started by going over the theoretical foundations of why MLPs work. A neural network is a class of parameterized functions. We create these neural networks to approximate functions that exist in our daily life or exist in science. It can be the translation for some text or the species of the animal in an image. But why do we believe neural networks can do this job? Well, it's because of the universal approximation theorem, which is the underlying mathematical principle of neural networks. It states that a neural network with sufficient number of hidden units can approximate any continuous function arbitrarily well, but the number of hidden units must grow to infinity to achieve infinite accuracy. So theoretically, neural networks can handle just any problem. However, MLPs have some drawbacks. In applications like transformers, MLPs consume too many parameters and typically less interpretable. So we are exploring alternatives to MLPs, which may have fewer parameters, more interpretable, and can achieve better accuracy. Actually, before the universal approximation theorem, there was an even more powerful theorem known as the Kolmogorov-Arnold representation theorem, which suggests that any multivariate continuous function can be represented as a composition of 2n plus 1 univariate functions, where n is the input dimension. So, in machine learning, can we try this idea to simplify the process of learning a multivariate function into learning a finite number of univariate functions? This sounds much more impressive than using neural networks to approximate multivariate functions with polynomials, because we need infinite hidden units to achieve infinite accuracy. But by using Kolmogorov-Arnold representation theorem, we can achieve infinite accuracy by a fixed width of the network. So why Kolmogorov-Arnold representation theorem hasn't been used in machine learning before, even it sounds so impressive? The reason is that while we mentioned learning some 1D functions, the theorem did not specify what this 1D function actually looked like. It can be non-smooth or fractal. So these functions may not be learnable in practice. So even though the theory is correct, it was considered not very useful. Moreover, this theorem only tells us that we only need two layers with 2n plus 1 terms in the hidden layer to represent various supervised learning tasks. Maybe we can try to generalize the Kolmogorov-Arnold representation to arbitrary widths and depths. And most functions in our daily lives and in science are smooth, so it is still possible for us to construct smooth Kolmogorov-Arnold representations. When it comes to constructing univariate functions, spline functions would be a good choice. A spline function is simply a type of piecewise function. When we have some sample points, for instance, let's say that we have n plus 1 sample points, t0 to tn, then there are n intervals between these points. We consider the curve in each interval as a k-degree polynomial, and it has continuous derivatives. It's important to note here that it has continuous derivatives, so k can be trained by using backpropagation. Spline functions generally perform well in function approximation tasks in low-dimensional space, so k chose to use B spline functions to parameterize these univariate functions. The biggest difference between k's and MLPs is that k's replace the fixed activation functions on nodes in MLPs with learnable activation functions on edges. These learnable activation functions are parameterized as B-splines, allowing them to represent complex 1D functions. The learnable spline activation functions in k's provide additional expressive power compared to the fixed activation like ReLU in MLPs. Just like MLPs, we can simply stack more k layers to make the network deeper and more powerful. Then let's have a look at the implementation tricks for optimizing k's. they use residual activation functions that are a sum of a basis function bx and a learnable spline function. The spline function is initialized to a small value that is close to zero, and the weight factor w is initialized according to the Xavier initialization, just like MLPs. And the spline grids are updated dynamically because the spline functions are defined within bounded interval, and the activation values are unbounded. So the spline grid is updated based on the input activations. A spline can reach arbitrarily accurate to the target function, as the grid can be made arbitrarily fine-grained. So can't use grid extension to fit a new fine-grained spline to an old coarse-grained spline, which means that we can first train a can with fewer parameters and extend it to a can with more parameters by making its spline grids finer without retraining the larger model from scratch. Cans offer interpretability and interactivity that MLPs cannot provide. The interpretability of cans is highlighted through techniques like sparsification, pruning, and symbolic simplification of the spline functions. By adding this interactivity to the model and visualizing its decision-making process, cans are able to uncover known relations in a transparent manner. This means that cans could facilitate more efficient knowledge discovery. And cans are more accurate than MLPs in special function fitting. The authors also compared the performance of MLPs and cans on solving PDEs using the same hyperparameters. And we can observe that cans converges faster and achieve lower loss compared to MLPs, and it had better scaling loss. The catastrophic forgetting is a challenge in AI systems that even GPT-4 struggles with. Currently, most neural networks are trained for specific tasks. They forget information from previous tasks while learning new ones. This occurs because MLPs lack notions of locality. Unlike human brains, we have local regions responsible for relevant skills. Humans don't override previously learned skills when learning new ones. Since the spline bases are local, cans can avoid catastrophic forgetting. A sample only affects a few nearby spline coefficients while keeping others unchanged. The biggest current issue with cans is the slow training process. With the same number of parameters, the training time of can is approximately 10 times longer than MLPs. The search space is simply too large. Searching through all combinations of nonlinear functions may not be computationally feasible. So when faster training of models is needed, MLPs are the better choice. However, if interpretability is more important and the training time is not a concern, the authors suggest giving can a try. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video is helpful to you, and see you in the next video.